Hello friends, let's apply Thevenin's theorem to a problem. So let's take a simple problem having a one source. So in this problem, I've just considered one source of 80 volt. And remaining elements are just resistances 10, 50, this is again 10, 50 and 60 ohm. Objective is to get current flowing through 60 ohm using Thevenin's theorem. Now, we are going to solve the problems in four steps. Step number one, calculation of VTH. As per the theorem, whenever we have to find out a VTH, we need to find out voltage between the terminals where load is connected. So I will first mark those terminals A and B, and for VTH, we need to remove that load resistance. So in this case, load resistance is 60 ohm. So remove RL, which is 60 ohm in our case. So I need to redraw the circuit. So circuit will become like this. As it is, and resistances except RL will be there in a circuit, and our job is to get VTH across terminals A and B. So whenever you see the circuit properly, how to get VTH? You need to trace a simple loop which will cover A and B points, meaning I will consider this loop 50 ohm, 10 ohm, which is covering this A and B points. So my objective is we need to find out voltage of these two branches in order to get VTH. So finally I'll come to know, I should know current flowing through 50 ohm and current flowing through 10 ohm in order to get VTH. So once you are sure what exactly we need to find out, then we will redraw the circuit and we will just find out those parameters. So in our case, our parameters are current flowing through 50 ohm and current flowing through 10 ohm. You can select any other path, but I am suggesting you take a shortest path having minimum number of elements. So this will be the shortest path for the problem. So to get our objectives, let's redraw the circuit one more time. Here it's very simple. These are the two terminals where elements are connected. So 80 volt, then to this 80 volt, I am having two resistances connected like this and two more resistances connected like this. This is 10 ohm, 50, 50 and 10 ohm. Point A is between this 10 and this 50. So this is point A. Point B between 50 and 10, point B. So it's a very simple circuit now. The current flowing through this branch, which I will denote as I50, because I am interested in knowing this current, and here I will denote this as I10. So since both these branches are connected to 80 volt source, current flowing through 50 ohm resistance will be 80 divided by 10 plus 50, which is 60, so 80 by 60. So through 50 ohm current flowing is 1.3333 ampere. Now for this I will denote it as current flowing through I 10 ohm equals same, because this branch is connected to 80 volt source only. So it's 80 divided by 50 plus 10 equals 80 divided by 60 equal to 1.3333 ampere. Now we got our objectives: current flowing through 10 ohm, current flowing through 50 ohm. Now what you have to do? We have to consider that loop which we have considered for calculation of VTH. So here we consider like this, plus minus VTH. So I will redraw that loop. So it will be like this, 50 and 10. These are the two points A and B. Okay. So here I consider A positive with respect to B and the voltage is VTH. For this 50 ohm, I got current like this, I50. Because of the direction downward, it will develop the voltage polarity in the current direction. Same way for this 10 ohm, I calculated current in downward direction, so voltage developed across it is also in the downward direction, meaning in a direction of current only. So for simple loop, I will apply KVL. So I will start from B point and come back to the same point. So minus plus, it is plus VTH, plus minus, it's minus. 50 is the resistance and I50 is the current. Minus plus, plus 10 is the resistance, I10 is the current equal to 0. VTH is the unknown. I will keep this on left hand side. Minus 50 into I50 will go that side. So it's 50 multiplied by I50, which is 1.3333 ampere. This will go other side, minus 10 multiplied by again same 1.3333. So if I solve, I will get VTH as 53.3333 volt. Since I am getting a positive answer, that means I assume A positive with respect to B is correct. So I will write here A positive with respect to B. Step number 1 is over. Let's go to step number 2, calculation of RTH. For calculation of RTH, we have to remove RL, in this case it is 60 ohm, and all voltage sources we need to short circuit and all current sources we need to open circuit. So in this case we are having only one voltage source and that is 80 volt. So 80 volt is short circuited. So I will consider this circuit. So in this circuit I will short circuit 80 volt. So I will get circuit like this. 80 volt is short circuited. This is 10 ohm, 50, 50 and 10. And these are the points A and B. Never forget to mention these points because this will change your circuit orientation altogether. Meaning, if I forget here A and B points, you simply say 10 and 50 in series, 50 and 10 in series, which is wrong because I should have A and B points intact. So I cannot say 50 and 10 are in series. Okay. So let's consider this point here. So this point I will consider as say C. If you see, this point is also C. This point is also C, and this point is also C. So let's redraw the circuit. So after redrawing the circuit, I will get from A to C there is 10 ohm. So A to C there is 10 ohm. Similarly, A to C there is 50 ohm. C to B, one more 50 ohm. And B to C there is 10 ohm. So I will get this 10 and 50 are in parallel. Same way, this 50 and 10 are in parallel. So 10 parallel 50, I will get 10 multiplied by 50 divided by 10 plus 50. If I solve, I will get answer 8.3333 ohm. Same way, this will give me 50 parallel 10, again one and the same, so it is 8.3333 ohm. So if I redraw the circuit considering this modification, it will be like this: from A and from B, two resistances I will get of the same value, 8.3333 and 8.3333. So if I solve, I will get RAB, which is nothing but RTH, as 8.3333 plus 8.3333, nothing but 16.6667 ohm. So now second step is over. Let's go to the third step. Third step is you have to draw Thevenin's equivalent circuit. So Thevenin equivalent circuit consists of VTH in series with RTH. Now before marking points A and B, we need to check VTH. So VTH I am getting 53.3333 volt, A positive with respect to B. So positive I have marked over here. So obviously this point will be A, this point will be B. This is VTH of the value 53.3333 volt. This is RTH of the value 16.6667 ohm. So this is a Thevenin's equivalent circuit. Now the last part is to get value of IL. So for this I will use Thevenin's equivalent circuit, and here I will connect a load resistance between points A and B. So load resistance I am connecting, which is of a 60 ohm, and getting a current IL is now very simple. So IL will be VTH divided by RTH plus RL. So if I substitute, 53.3333 divided by 16.6667, RL is 60, I will get IL equal to 0.6957 ampere, and the orientation I will get is vertical, and I am getting a positive answer for IL. So direction that I have considered is correct, which is downward. So this is the end of problem number 1, where we have used Thevenin's theorem. In subsequent videos, we will solve more numericals based on this. Thank you.